Hey, Dan Plowman here. One of the questions I've had come in, which I think is a great question, is how do I convert leads better? Well, I know for me, conversion became an issue when I realized I was receiving leads in abundance, but I started to go down the path of, well, these leads aren't really very good. And that wasn't the case. It was actually me, the language I was using, and the way that I was handling leads and creating opportunities in my language for people so that I could get the right response so that the lead would actually go down a path of opportunity. And that's really what creates a good lead. Quite often it's the questions we're asking, the way we're asking them, that shuts a lead off. And you don't want to do that. If you use it in the right language, you'll be amazed at how leads will go down a different path. And that path that I'm talking about is opportunity. So you can convert leads better if you can understand the language that's critical as leads come in. There's different languages for different types of leads. We'll show you that. I want you to know that leads can be converted at a much higher and better level if we understand the different types of language that we need to use that are specific to the scenario. So, all right, let me give you an example of what I'm talking about when I talk about how to convert leads better and what language to use specifically. Quite often, I would talk to people on the phone and I would ask them, are you looking to buy or move now? Are you looking to sell first or buy first? And I haven't even developed a relationship with that person yet. And their natural response to that is going to be pushback. No, no, I'm just looking. That's what people do, right? So, you know, as I started to realize this was a conditioned response just to get me off the phone because they got what they wanted, I started to realize that I could use and did use different language that just kind of softened things and kept it in a relationship mode. So I would say things like, is there anything else I could help you with right now? Or is that what you're looking for? Is that the area you're looking for? I would always leave an answer to their question with a question so they kept the conversation going. And what was interesting was before they knew it, before I knew it, we were actually having a conversation. You'll find when you're able to converse with someone, they ask you a question, you ask them a question. After three of those back and forth, their guard starts to come down. And you'll build a bit of a relationship. Now, what you don't want to do is break that or kill that by going in for the sales close too early. Don't do it. Just go in for the opportunity to ask to follow up. Just go in for the opportunity to stay in touch. Keep it soft. Look, these people aren't calling us, reaching out to us, or leaving lead information online, knowing that you're going to call them and invite them in their home and list their home within 24 hours. That's what we would love, but that's not how it works. So if we're able to understand this, use the right language specifically, and just go for the follow-up. Just go for the relationship. If you, at the end of every day, had 5 or 6 new relationship opportunities going into your CRM, that's about 25 to 30 a week. Think about that. That's over 100 a month. Do you think you'll list more homes and do more deals? I promise you will. I hope that helps.